We're going to talk about the discriminant in this video. So if we look at the quadratic formula, x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a, the discriminant is this part underneath the square root symbol, the b squared minus 4ac. So it's defined to be exactly that, which if you put in the values of a, b, and c, you'll get a number. So the discriminant is the value of b squared minus 4ac. Now, if you plug in values, there's only three things that can happen. Either it's greater than 0, so it's a positive number, or it's equal to 0, or it's less than 0, which means it's a negative number. So if you think about the quadratic form, we're just looking in the numerator. It's going to be negative b plus or minus the square root of some positive number, okay, all over 2a. So if you think about what's going to go on, whatever happens to b, whatever b is, you're going to add some positive number to it, and that'll be different than when you subtract some positive number. Actually, it's going to be over 2a, right? So when the discriminant is greater than 0, you're going to get two different solutions, and you're taking the square root of a positive number, so it's going to be a real number. So when b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0, you're going to have two real numbers. Two real numbers for solutions. Okay, let's move these down. Don't want to get confused. Okay, now what about if b squared minus 4ac equals 0? Well, what would that look like? You'd have negative b plus or minus the square root of 0 over 2a. So basically, you're going to get negative b plus 0 and then negative b minus 0. That's the same thing. You're going to get negative b over 2a. This happens when whatever you have was a perfect square, basically, and you could have factored it. So you're only going to get one real solution, because you're not going to get any negative numbers under the square root, so you're going to get one real solution. In fact, instead of saying two real numbers, I'm going to say two real solutions. All right, now what happened if what's underneath the square root is a negative number? So you've got some negative number over 2a. Well, you're going to get negative, that's going to give you I, right? You're going to take the square root of some negative number, so you're going to do plus something with an I in it and then minus something with an I in it. You're going to get two different solutions. In fact, they're going to be complex conjugates. So you're going to get two complex conjugates for solutions. Two complex solutions. And I'm going to say a little bit more about this. They're actually conjugates. They're called complex conjugates, and they're not real, that means, right? Just keep in mind, they're not real. Two complex solutions. So the discriminant tells you ahead of time if your solutions, if you just check out what the discriminant is, you know if your solutions are going to be two real solutions, one real solution, or two complex solutions. And this is going to help us when we do graphing. It's going to be important to be able to tell when you're graphing something whether it goes through the x-axis. More about that later, but for now, the discriminant will tell us something about our solutions. So let's do a couple problems. All right, so we're going to use the discriminant to determine the number and types of solutions of each equation. So here's the first one, 2x squared minus 3x plus 4 equals 0. Well, you could use the quadratic formula, the whole thing, and then at the end, analyze it and say, hey, is two real solutions, one real solutions, or two complex, not real solutions. Or the easy way, simply do the discriminant. Because it's not asking us for the solutions, it's only asking us for the types of solutions. So let's just do that. B squared minus 4ac in this case. Well, b squared, negative 3 times negative 3 is 9, minus 4 times ac. 2 times 4 is 8. And you don't even have to figure out what number that is, but all you have to do is decide, is that going to be a negative number, a positive number, or 0? So think about it. 9 minus 32. Is that going to be positive or negative? It's going to be negative. So what happens? The discriminant is negative. So the part under the square root will be negative. So you are going to get two complex, which means they're not real, right? Solutions. And they're actually two complex conjugates. Does that make sense to you? The part under the square root in the quadratic formula would be negative. So just to show you once again, it's because you'd have x equals negative b. If you were going to do the whole thing, you'd have 3 plus or minus the square root of some negative number, right? Over 2a. All right, you know you're going to have some I in there someplace, and that's why it ends up being complex. Okay? All right, let's do a different problem now. All right, so let's find out what kind of solutions, without actually solving this and writing the solutions, what are the solutions going to be real, two or one of them, and or are they going to be complex conjugates? All right, well, we need to put this in standard form so we could identify A, B, and C. A is 4, B is negative 12, C is 9. So I want to know what is B squared minus 4AC, that's the discriminant. So B squared, negative 12 times negative 12 is 144, minus 4 times AC. 4 times 9 is 36. Okay, so I've got 4 times 36 is 144. Ah, I get 0. What did that mean? That means if I were going to plug it into the quadratic formula, I'd have plus the square root of 0 and minus the square root of 0. So I'm going to get one real solution. Now, why is that? Look at that original problem. 4x squared minus 12x plus 9. If somebody said to solve this and you just factored it, it's a perfect square. Even if you wrote it as 2x minus 3 times 2x minus 3. So if you solved it, you would end up getting just one solution. 2x is 3. Or x is 3 halves. So if you were going to solve it, you could see why it ends up only being one real solution. But the idea here is you're not having to go through all that. All it's asking you is about the types of roots and by the types of solutions. Root is another word for solutions in math. So it has one real solution. That'll happen anytime it could have been factored because it was a perfect square. Let's try to get one more in here. Let's find out about these roots. A is 8, B is negative 2, C is negative 7. And you all know you could always put the video on pause and try a problem before I do it. So let's do B squared minus 4AC. B squared is negative 2 times negative 2, that's 4, minus 4 times AC. So I've got 8 times negative 7, that's negative 56. All right, now let's just look at that. Is this going to be a positive or a negative number? It's going to be 4 plus something, right? It's greater than 0. I don't care what it is. But that means if you did the quadratic formula, if you were actually having to solve and get the solution, you would end up with plus the square root of some positive number and minus the square root of some positive number, right? You'd have negative b plus that number and negative b, whatever it is, minus that number. So this one is going to be 2 real solutions. Let me ask you one more thing. What if the discriminant was a positive square? What if b squared minus 4ac? What if b squared minus 4ac was a perfect square? like 36. You'd have plus the square root of 36 and minus the square root of 36. So you know what? If it ends up being a perfect square, they're going to be two rational solutions. You won't even have any square roots. So that tells you even a little bit more information, just in case you were interested.